My name is Abhishek Khurana, guys, and I am a 6 times 99 percentiler in CAT. I hope my voice is audible to you, and I am visible to you. Guys, can you hear me? May I know who are online? Who guys are online? Can you please have a round of voice so that I get to know that I am audible and visible to every one of you? See, today we'll be starting the all important topic of critical reasoning. Now see, my name is Abhishek Khurana. I've done BCom honors from Punjab University. I've done MBA in marketing from NMIMS 2009-2011 batch. I've been a plus educator on Unacademy for the past 1.5 years. Now, I have 9 years of teaching experience and I've been 6 times 99 percentiler in CAT. I have a passion to teach for aptitude exams, and I have hundreds of my students in top B schools of the country. Now see, today we'll be starting the topic of verbal ability. It starts, the major topics are reading comprehension, vocabulary, critical reasoning, parajumbles, summary based questions, finding the odd sentence in the paragraph, complete the paragraph by adding the last sentence, sentence completion by fill in the blanks, sentence correction which is sort of grammar based, fact inference judgment based questions, and there will be regular doubt sessions also. Now see, today we'll be starting with the critical reasoning. As we all know, critical reasoning is obviously a very essential part of common admission test and other management entrance tests. See, it involves a very short argument that is followed by a question. Now, here you have to choose the best alternative out of the given 4 options. See, now, what are the building blocks of an argument? Most of the times, there are 4 parts to an argument. Most of the time, not every time. I'll tell you the names and then I'll tell it in detail. Mostly the 4 types are premise, conclusion, background, and counterpoint. See, premise is something that supports the author's conclusion. Now, it may be a fact given by the author, or it might be the opinion of the author. Conclusion is something that represents the author's claim. It has to be always supported by at least 1 premise. Now, background is always fact-based. You cannot include any opinion in this. Now, so it is not always present in the argument. Counterpoint is something that opposes or goes against the conclusion of author in some way. Now, which means, it might be something against the premise. It is also not always present. We'll discuss this how. See, let us say I'll give you a short question and then I'll tell you what is premise in this, what is counter premise, what is conclusion and what is background. First of all, I'll read this question for you. The expansion of runways at the Chandigarh airport will allow for larger planes to travel to and from Chandigarh. These new planes will create a large amount of noise nuisance for residents who live near the airport. However, many of the residents work in construction and the contract to expand the runways has been awarded to local construction company. Thus, the expansion of the runway will lead to an increased quality of life for the residents of its neighborhood. Now, this is the diagram. Now, I have marked background, counterpoint, premise and conclusion by four different colors. See, background is this. The expansion of runways at the Chandigarh airport will allow for larger planes to travel to and from Chandigarh. Now, premise is something. See, what is the conclusion? The expansion of the runway will lead to an increased quality of life for the residents of its neighborhood. Now, what is the premise? It is that many of the residents work in construction and contract to expand the runway has been awarded to local construction company. This works in favor of this. Now, what is the counterpoint? These new planes will create a large amount of noise, a nuisance for residents who live near the airport. This is the counterpoint. So, I hope till now you get to know what exactly is the role of these four statements. Now, how to solve this question? See, first is identify the question. There are 8 to 10 of types of questions asked in this. You have to identify what type of question it is. Then you have to deconstruct the argument, state the goal and then work from wrong to right. Getting my point, guys? See, I'll tell you how to solve this. Now, first of all, I'll discuss you what are the types of questions. You can be asked to find the assumption, conclusion, evaluate, find the flaw, strengthen, weaken, inference, or explain a discrepancy, or the describe the role of a particular statement in an argument. Getting my point, guys? Now, see, what is the example of an assumption? See, an assumption is which, if we were to insert the assumption into the argument, it would make the argument stronger. Without the assumption, the argument would not hold true. See, let us say the argument is the car is black. Therefore, the car cannot belong to Ajay. Now, obviously, we have an assumption over here that Ajay does not have a black car. If this assumption does not hold true, this whole conclusion will not hold true. Now, we'll discuss this with an example. MTC, which is methyl tetrachloride, is a chemical found in some pesticide, glues and sealants. Exposure to MTC can cause people to develop asthma. In order to halve the nation's asthma rate, the government plans to ban all products containing MTC. Now, the government's plan to halve the nation's asthma rate relies on which of the following assumptions? You have to go through this argument for 2 minutes and then you have to tell me which might be the assumption of the government. Now you have 2 minutes to solve this, guys. Any answers from your side? Your side? Hello, Aryan. Aryan, your English is not good. Don't worry, we'll discuss it. Aryan, what you can do is you can regularly attend this class and then you can crack the CAT verbal section. Aryan, have you been attending these classes? Tell me, Aryan, be honest. Aryan, are you talking about the RC reading comprehension? RCC, what exactly do you mean, Aryan? Can you please elaborate? Aryan, what do you mean by RCC? Can you please elaborate, Aryan? Aryan, that I guess you have to manage. You can also get the recorded lessons from here. Okay, first of all, we'll discuss this question. See, okay, what exactly are in 1 minute? See, if MTC is a chemical found in some pesticides, glues and sealants, and exposure to MTC can cause people to develop asthma, government wants to do what? Halve the nation's asthma rate. What is the assumption? That exposure to this is leading to at least half of the nation's asthma cases. See, if it would have been dealing with only 40% of the cases, then how can government halve the nation's asthma rate? I hope you have understood this, guys. Now, solve this question, guys. Studies show that impoverished families give away larger percentage of their income in charitable donations than do wealthy families. As a result, the fundraising consultants recommend that charities direct their marketing efforts towards individuals and families from lower socioeconomic classes in order to maximize the dollar value of incoming donations. Okay, you are talking about SRCC exam pattern. when is your exam, Aryan? Best explains why the consultant's reasoning is flawed. No, when exactly is the SRCC exam, Aryan? When is the SRCC exam, Aryan? Because then only we can devise a schedule for you to study SRCC exam, no? Then why didn't you fill the exam? Why didn't you fill the exam, Aryan? See, here the flaw in the argument is that even if they donate a larger percentage, it does not mean that they donate the larger absolute dollar value. I hope this is understood to you. So deep statement is a flaw. Now we'll discuss some of the questions which are based on finding the assumption, which is the first topic of this. Okay, I'll just change the color. Just a second, guys. I guess this is not helping much. I guess this looks somewhat better than at least it is at least readable, guys. Oh, so Aryan, if you did not fill the form, then what solution do we have right now? Others, take 2 minutes to solve this question and find the assumption, guys. Okay, Salman Khan, see, we discussed that because you have somehow poor academics, so you will have to make for a very good CAT score. So what you can do, Salman Khan, right now is, see, what are your college timings, Salman Khan? Tell me the college timings and I will prepare a schedule for you. Okay, Salman Khan, can you study in the morning? Possible for you? Tell me, Salman Khan, how much time can you devote? Four hours, 6 hours. How much time can you devote easily? Okay, Salman Khan, what you have to do is 3 hours for your, let us say if you can take it for 6 hours, then you have to study maths for 3 hours, 1.5 hour LR, 1.5 hour maths. If you can study for 4 hours, 2 hour for maths, 1 hour for LR, 1 hour for English. See, 6 hours I have already told you. See, 50% of the time for maths, 25% each for verbal and then LRDI. For maths, you have to start with arithmetic and English. You can start from here only. I'll start teaching you with this only. Okay, solve this question. See, I'll read the question. To decrease the number of crimes in city Y, the city's police commissioner proposed taking some police officers from low crime districts of the city and moving them to high crime districts of the city. His proposal is based on city Y crime data that show that the number of crimes in any district of the city decreases when additional police officers are moved into that district. The police commissioner's proposal depends upon which of the following assumptions. Now, read the options and take 2-3 minutes, guys. Actually, yes, it is possible for you, Salman Khan. Yes, it is possible for you. Salman Khan, have you solved this question? Salman, yes, it is possible for you because for disabled category the percentage is 45%. कितना परसेंट है आपका सलमान खान? सलमान खान कितना परसेंट आपका अभी? See, the answer to this will be that we must hope that districts of the see the districts of the city from which police officers are removed do not experience significant crime increases shortly after the removal of these officers. So this is the assumption on which the entire argument is based. Okay, Salman Khan 1248 from Assam. Okay. Then Salman Khan, to graduation mein you are 62. Salman Khan, because you are in the disability quota, you can also still go through the IIMs. I am very much sure. Okay, Salman Khan, now solve this question. And Aryan, you also. Salman Khan, aim for 99.5. I am seriously telling you, it is very much possible. Till then, I'll read the question for you guys. Although there has been great scientific debate for decades over global warming, most scientists now agree that human activity is causing the Earth's temperature to rise. Though predictions vary, many global warming experts believe that average global temperatures will rise between 3 and 8 degrees Fahrenheit during the next century. Such an increase would cause an alarming rise in sea levels, displacing millions of people by destroying major population centers along the world's coastlines. Which of the following is an assumption in support of the argument's conclusion? I'll show you the options, guys. These are the five options, and now you'll have to give the answer, guys. Salman Khan, exact cutoffs, I'll have to check. See, exact cutoffs you have, Salman Khan, I'll suggest you one thing. I'll suggest you one thing, that you should put a mail under, put a mail to concerned IIM and ask them what is the reliance for the disability quota in your particular IIM. Then you'll be able to get the exact information. See, this general information, this specific information is not mentioned on the website. I have checked it because I know you had asked me a couple of times before. Then I checked it, but not specifically mentioned on the website. So what I'll suggest is go through this on the mail them this. I hope it is clear, guys. Salman Khan, now tell me the answer of this question. Have you solved it, Salman Khan? See, the obvious answer to this is that the new technologies development in the next century will not divert rising seas from the world's coastal cities. Because if it does so, then this conclusion obviously does not hold true. I hope this part is clear to you guys. Salman, see, what is the assumption? That most of the people will be, millions of people will be displaced. If new technological developments in the next century will divert rising seas there from the coastal cities, then it will not happen. So Salman Khan, this is the only possible explanation for this. If the first option is the correct answer, why do we need to check the other option, Salman Khan? Salman Khan, is the explanation clear to you? Okay, I'll give you another question. Take 2 minutes and read this question and then I'll move to the options. Salman Khan, if you have read this, now see the options. What is the answer, Salman Khan? Any answers for this, Salman Khan? Shall I show you the question again? Read the question again and then What's the answer, Salman Khan, from your side? See, Salman Khan, see, all of the if you have read the information, all of the following claims are either implied or made explicitly in the above advertisement, except this: the hitted fat driver helped the last 12 major. See, the claim never said that these clubs made help them win this situation. I hope you understand this, guys. All other things are implicitly or explicitly mentioned there, but not this one, not the second point, guys. Let us move to the next. I'll read because the right side is not visible to you guys. Researchers studying the spread of black plague in 16th century England claim that certain people survived the epidemic because they carried a genetic mutation known as Delta 32 that is known to prevent the bacteria that causes the plague from overtaking the immune system. I guess the rest is visible to you guys. So take 2 minutes and then solve this question. What's the answer, Salman Khan? And what's this answer, Aryan? See, the question is, researchers studying this, the options are this. Now, the obvious answer here is that the plague itself does not cause genetic mutation such as Delta 32. If plague itself has caused the genetic mutation, then it is obvious that it will be present in those, and then obviously they must have survived. Next question. I'll read the question because the right side might be missing. The popular notion that a tree's age can be determined by counting the number of internal rings in its trunk is generally true. However, to help regulate the internal temperature of the tree, the outermost layers of wood of the Brazilian ash often peel away when the temperature exceeds 95 degrees Fahrenheit. Now you have to solve this question accordingly. You can read rest of the statement, guys. Okay, these are the options, guys. Have you guys solved this question? Okay, I'll give you 2 more minutes and then solve this, guys. Okay, see, the obvious answer to this question is that the number of rings that will be lost when the temperature exceeds 95 degrees Fahrenheit is certainly not predictable. Because had it been predictable, we would have been able to calculate that how many rings would have been lost and then easily calculate this. But this certainly is not possible. Getting my point, guys? Now, next question, guys. Okay, I hope till the questions we have discussed it is clear to every one of you. Now, we'll continue with these questions in tomorrow's class. Till then, if you guys have any doubts, you can mark your doubts and then we can continue with your doubts. Are there any doubts till now? So, we'll discuss this in tomorrow's class. We'll continue. So, don't forget to attend tomorrow's class, guys. And best of luck for your CAT preparation. So tomorrow guys, let us meet tomorrow.